Thank you. to page 35. God, our rock, is perfect in every way, long-suffering and full of mercy. Take pity on both parents and children, for forgiveness and mercy are yours. You are just in bringing life beyond death, for in your hand is the care of every soul. May your eyes watch over us with mercy, for you do not blot out all memory of us. To you all flesh must come, and you will pardon their sins. God, if you should mark the wrong we do, our God, who could stand? As a father is tender to his children, so will you be tender to us. You guard us when we go out and when we come in. In the shadow of your wings you shelter us. Even darkness will not darken our spirit, for in your light we see light. God, bring us peace, and may your faithfulness give us spirit strength. Support us, God, when we are silent through grief. Comfort us when we are bent down with sorrow. Help us as we bear the weight of our loss. God, our rock and our redeemer, give us strength. The top of page 37. Bilahamavit lanetzach, umacha dunai dima me al kol panim, viagon vanacha yase me al kol lev, ki ladunai ha Yeshua, vahabe imo fedut. And I'm going to ask you to keep a finger in page 37, and we're turning forward to the memorial prayer, which you'll find on page 53. Would you please stand? El male rachamim shochein bamromim, hametzeh menuchanachona, tachat kanfecha shichina, b'ma'alot kadoshim utahorim, Kuzoha harakia mazhirim, et nishmat Menachem ben Moshe, shechalach lo'olamo, ana ba'al harachamim, hastirechu b'seta kanafecha lo'olamim, utzro b'tzroch hachayim et nishmato, Adonai hu nachalato, v'yanuach b'shalom al mishkavo v'noma, amen. God, full of compassion, whose presence is over us, grant perfect rest beneath the shelter of your presence with the holy and pure on high, who shine as the lights of heaven. To Menachem, who's gone to his everlasting home, source of mercy, cover him in the shelter of your wings forever and bind his soul into the gathering of life. It is God who is his heritage. May his dear soul be at peace in its place of rest. And let us say, Amen. And now we return to the middle of page 37, and we're going to say together in Hebrew and then in English. Adonai natan v'Adonai lakach, yehi shem Adonai mevorach. God has given, and God has taken away. May God's name be blessed. Please be seated. The Hebrew word for a eulogy, a hesped, comes from a root meaning something like to sing the song of a person's life. It goes right back to the Hebrew Bible when Abraham goes to bury his beloved wife Sarah in the cave of Machpelah. The Torah says he goes, lispod l'sarah v'livkota, to eulogize Sarah and to cry for her. And that has been the model for Jewish mourning from that day to this. The idea of singing the song of a person's life could not be more appropriate for Menachem Presler, whose long life was shaped by his love of beautiful music. Born in Magdeburg, Germany on December the 16th, 1923, his home, like all those of middle-class intelligentsia, featured a piano. Unlike many young people who learn the piano, he fell in love with it, and music became the central organizing principle of his life. The beauty of music must have been a great comfort when his world was turned upside down by Kristallnacht in 1938. The family clothing store was ransacked. The very next day, he was thrown out of school. Thankfully, his immediate family realized that the priority was to get out of Germany as soon as possible. Using their Polish passports, they went to Italy on the pretext of a holiday, but sailed from Trieste to what was then Palestine. Sadly, the rest of the family weren't able to follow, and his uncles, aunts, and grandparents were all murdered in concentration camps. Once settled in Tel Aviv, Menachem was able to take lessons from Leo Kestenberg, another refugee from Nazi Germany, and made his debut with the Palestine Symphony Orchestra as the soloist in Saint-Saëns' Piano Concerto. It seems appropriate that his Hebrew name, Menachem, means the one who comforts, as he was renowned for the beauty and the sensitivity of his interpretations of piano music. But it is important to add that he was extremely dedicated and determined as well. When he traveled to the US in 1946 to take part in the Debussy competition, 27 solo piano works were required to be known by heart. Less than a dozen were available then on sheet music in Palestine. But that didn't stop Menachem Presler. He got the additional scores in New York, memorized them on the transcontinental train using a dummy keyboard, and went on to win the competition. His talent was so evident that he was soon giving concerts around America, and even recorded an album of music from the Paul Heinrich Katharine Hepburn film, Song of Love. Menachem Presler had a sensitivity and a depth to his playing that must have been informed by the extraordinary circumstances of his own life's journey. His US debut with the Philadelphia Orchestra, playing Schumann's Piano Concerto, was met with rave reviews and led to several more appearances with the orchestra. By 1955, he had released recordings of solo piano music by Grieg and Prokofiev and joined the music school at Indiana University in Bloomington, where he remained for the rest of his life. Somehow, in the midst of his busy professional life, he found time to meet and marry Sarah, with whom he had two children, Amitai and Edna. Fittingly, for someone whose very name means comforter, he had a gift for making feel better by his presence, which made him an extraordinary and beloved teacher. I want to quote what Menachem himself said about teaching. This is what he said. While the concerts give you the ability to show all you have, the ability to have people share that which you find beautiful, that which you find life-giving, because I feel that my reason to be alive is to teach and to play, I am more grateful for the teaching. Because when you play a concert, you have the applause, which is wonderful. You are paid immediately, which is marvelous. But when you teach, You plant a seed in the heart and mind of a young person. In a way, they become your children. End quote. That was really an important life principle to him. He gave his last lesson via Zoom just a week before he died. Part of his legacy is in the many students whom he inspired. But another very important part is the Beaux-Arts Trio, which he founded after an approach from Parlophone Records at the Tanglewood Music Festival in 1954. He approached the violinist Daniel Guier and the cellist Bernard Greenhouse to join him. Within 2 years, they had released an LP featuring the works of Ravel and Fauré and had an international series of concerts to fit around their teaching commitments. Though their London debut at the Festival Hall didn't have the numbers they deserved, within 2 years, they were playing to large audiences at the Wigmore Hall. With a reviewer describing the rendition of the Beethoven piano trios as, and again I quote, as near perfection as one could get in an imperfect world. Though the violinist and cellist changed over the years, Menachem Prezler was a constant throughout the trio's long existence. They gave farewell concerts at the Wigmore Hall in 2007. A lesser musician might have considered that at 85, maybe the time had come to retire. But Menachem Prezler was a man who wanted to bring beautiful music to the world as long as he had breath in his body. So he did something extraordinary. He revived his solo career, including a return to Germany for the 70th anniversary of Kristallnacht. He played with the Berlin Philharmonic, conducted by Simon Rattle. He played Mozart's Concerto number 23, K488. The man who had lived up to his name, Menachem, the Comforter, was acknowledged for the gifts he had brought to the world well into his 90s. He received an honorary doctorate from the Royal Academy of Music in 2015. And he released a disc of Mozart piano concertos that was praised as showing an intellectual and emotional grasp of music second to none. Much of the happiness of his last years came from having Annabelle by his side, and he dedicated a new album of Debussy music to her when he was a mere 94 years old. Menachem Prezler, whose very name means the one who consoles, brought extraordinary beauty into a world that has seen too much suffering. And his legacy will certainly continue through his pupils. We are all diminished by his passing. Zeche Tzadik Livracha, may the memory of the righteous be for a blessing. Amen.
I first encountered Menachem Prezler's magical piano playing as a very young boy. I attended a concert here in London that Menachem gave with his Beaux-Arts Trio. The minute he began to play, I was captivated, as were so many others. Prezler's way of making music was a revelation, but his meteoric rise to the top always seemed like a dream come true to him. Perhaps that's how he felt Arriving as a very young man in Hollywood shortly after the end of the Second World War, taking lessons from Bruno Walter, playing ping pong with Jascha Heifetz and Franz Waxman, dining with Thomas Mann, astounding conductors such as Toscanini and Stokowski, or even performing a private soiree in Alma Mahler's residence. In the sweltering summer heat of Beverly Hills, he asked Frau Mahler if he might be permitted to remove his jacket. The response was swift and direct. "Young man, as far as I'm concerned, you can undress completely." But just a few years prior to Presler's almost mahogany-like experience, he could never dream something like this would be possible. Back in 1939, he climbed aboard a train in Magdeburg with his parents and siblings. Their only mission as Jews was to stay alive. Max Jakob Presler, as he was then known, was forced to leave everything behind: friends, family, the piano on which Menachem, as he would later choose to call himself, already played so exquisitely. "We cannot remain here," his father had decided and planned their escape. That his plan succeeded, that after hours of agonized waiting, their entry visas for Palestine were finally issued and a last ship was available. All of this was pure luck for him and for us. That Menachem would choose me, of all people, in 2002, to join his trio, a 27-year-old violinist who was seriously wet behind the ears, is something which I, in turn, would never have dreamed possible. But instead of an understandable caution that divided the 50 years between us, I encountered a man who was heartfelt, generous, witty, and tremendously kind. Self-importance, arrogance, or attitude were foreign to him. Together with the outstanding cellist, my great friend Antonio Meneses, we toured the world for 8 years. We gave almost 400 concerts. In 53 years of Beaux-Arts Trio history, there were 5 violinists and 3 cellists, but of course only 1 pianist. It would take 73 years, however, until Presler was to be reconciled with Germany. Menachem wanted officially to become a citizen again of the country in which he was born and to whose culture he felt so intrinsically connected. He asked me to help him achieve his wish, so I lobbied the German government on his behalf. Familiar phrases such as "it could be difficult" and even "we're not sure we could make this work" were plentiful. And then, sure enough, in 2012, aged 88, he did receive German citizenship once more. The great and the good of Berlin turned out to celebrate him and to bask in his sunshine. "What should I say at the ceremony?" he asked hesitantly. "That I'm honored?" "No," I replied, "that you are pleased. It's your birthright." For Menachem Presler, each concert, each rehearsal, each time he sat down at a piano was the beginning of a new journey. A wrong accent in a phrase of music was the greatest insult he could have possibly imagined. "Worse than an insult between a husband and wife," he would say. It was astonishing to behold how he absorbed the music and then retransmitted it. With him, one became part of a process of origination, and his music making retained the same freshness as in his early recordings when he was 27. That's not enough. You don't dig deep enough. Never place yourself above a Beethoven, a Mozart, a Schubert. All of these were typical Preslerisms. And yet his humility knew no bounds. On the 15th of October 2003, the Beaux-Arts Trio played at the gala opening of the Detroit Symphony Orchestra's new chamber music hall. At the same time, a benefit concert was taking place in the main hall with saxophonist Branford Marsalis and the jazz legend pianist Oscar Peterson, now wheelchair-bound after a stroke. Oscar Peterson, born in 1925, was himself 2 years younger than Pressler, and their careers were both launched early on. It transpired that Pressler and Peterson had met once in New York in the early 1950s. They had both appeared on a cooking show for television. When we heard that Mr. Peterson was due to play on the same evening in Detroit, Menachem insisted on meeting him. As luck would have it, our respective concerts finished at exactly the same time, and we hurried to the communal green room. Minutes later, Oscar Peterson was wheeled into our dressing room. We were still dressed in our formal white tie and tails. Mr. Peterson was wearing a red velvet tuxedo. Menachem went straight over to Oscar Peterson. He bent down and he put his hands on Peterson's knees. "Mr. Peterson, my name is Menachem Pressler. I am the pianist of the Beaux-Arts Trio. We met many, many years ago on a cookery show. You probably do not remember me. I just wanted to say that you are one of the most outstanding pianists of our time. I admire you and I love you." To witness these two giants, each one representing the very best that their instruments and musical worlds had to offer, was an unforgettable moment. Just like every moment with Menachem was unforgettable. I like to think of him right now debating with Beethoven about tempi and articulation. I have no doubt who will win that argument. There is not a phrase in these great works that I can hear or perform without sensing what he would have said. We've heard what he said about teaching, but there's one other beautiful quote. "I'm glad that I've been able to transmit something of my experiences. To know that you have a part in making that person a sun in his own universe, no matter how small, that is a wonderful feeling." May his memory be a blessing.
And now, if you'd like to look at the service booklet, we're going to hear the Mozart Rondo in A minor, K511.
Thank you.
We return now to the service book on page 37. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher yatzen etchem badin, v'zan v'chilkel etchem badin, v'hemit etchem badin, v'yodeh mispar kulchem badin, v'ati lecha chazir lecha chayot chem badin, baruch atah Adonai, m'chaye hamiti. Page 41. Protect me, God, for in you I take shelter. I keep the eternal always before me. For with God at my right hand I shall not be shaken. Where could I go from your spirit? Where could I flee from your presence? If I climb to heaven, you are there. There too, if I lie down in the depths, if I fly on wings to the dawn and dwell at the sea's horizon, even there your hand would lead me, your right hand would uphold me. If I ask darkness to cover me and light to be night around me, that darkness would not be dark to you, but night as bright as day, and darkness like the light. Search me, God, and know my heart. Prove me and know my thoughts. See if the path to despair is within me, and lead me in the path of eternity. Would you please stand? We continue now at the top of page 43. Elohai neshama shenatata bo tehorahi, ata varata, ata yitzarta, va'ata nafachta bo, va'ata meshamra lo olam, va'ata natalta ota lechaye olam, baruch ata Adonai, hamachazir neshamot lametim. My God, the soul you have given him is pure, for you created it, you formed it, and breathed it into him. You care for it forever and have taken it to life everlasting. Blessed are you, our living God, who brings the dead to life everlasting. Al mokomo yavov shalom. May his soul come to its resting place in peace. Amen. Please be seated. And now at this deepest moment in the service, we're going to hear the Bach aria. And now we return to the prayer book on page 45. Eternal God, in your hands the souls of the living, the spirits of all creatures. We turn to you in grief as well as in joy. For your mercy is always with us, and your love and truth support us at all times. Though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we fear no harm. For you are beside us, your rod and staff, they comfort us. God, you have taken from us Menachem Preisler. In your mercy, bear him to life everlasting. May the memory of his long life and his many good deeds bring blessing and comfort to those who mourn for him. May it give them the courage and strength to continue bravely in their daily life, trusting you in their hearts. God of mercy, help those who mourn and comfort them in their grief. Lighten their darkness, console them in their sorrow. It is said, as a mother comforts her child, so will I myself comfort you. Never again shall your sun set, nor your moon withdraw its light, because God shall be your everlasting light, and the days of your mourning shall be ended. And now we turn to Kaddish, the mourner's prayer, which you'll find on page 54, with the transliteration on page 55. I'm going to ask you please to stand. Often in Jewish tradition, this is left to the family, but as I said at the beginning of the service, when we've lost one of the Gedolei Hador, one of the great people of our generation, we're all bereaved. So if you gentlemen would like to join me, and if you'd like to join us, we're going to recite the Kaddish. Yit gadol v'yit kadash mei rabah, ba'alma divrach chirutei v'yamlich malchutei. V'chayei chon v'yomei chon, v'chayei t'chol beit Yisrael, ba'agala v'zman kariv v'imru, amen. Yehei shmei rabam v'rach le'olam, amnei almaya. Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'a v'yitraman v'yitnasei. V'yitadar v'yitalei v'yitalal, shmei t'kisha b'richu. Le'ela min kol b'chata v'shirata, Tushbachata v'nechmata, diamiram ba'alma v'imru, amen. Yehei shlama rabba min shmaya, v'chayim alenu v'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. O se shalom b'mromav, hu ya'ase shalom, alenu v'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Page 56. B'yadcha navkid rucho, v'imrucho, Adonai lo v'lo nira. Into your hand we commend his spirit, and with his spirit his body also. God is with him, we shall not fear. And now to the many people who loved him with us in the synagogue and watching us on the live stream, we say, Hamakom yenachem etchem b'toch sha'ar ha'avilim. May the all-present comfort you, together with all who mourn. Amen. Please be seated. We're going to conclude our service now with a Beethoven piano trio and Richard Strauss' beautiful song you're going to hear. Service is now concluded. We will, of course, be mentioning Menachem's name this coming Shabbat before we say Kaddish. Could I ask you now to start to make your way out of the synagogue?